Knee joint, range of motion. Assessing the range of motion is an essential component of any joint examination. It not only reveals limitations to movement, but can also provide important diagnostic clues about the etiology and progress of a disorder. The knee joint is stabilized by several different structures, including the menisci, the cruciate ligaments, the collateral ligaments, and the joint capsule. Its most important function is to act as a hinge. It allows a physiological flexion between 120 and 150 degrees. Extension rarely exceeds 0 degrees and is considered pathological if greater than 5 degrees. To assess the range of motion, start by maximally flexing and extending the knee. It is especially important that the patient is able to achieve maximal extension, which is essential for a normal gait. Extension can be limited, for example, following reconstruction of the anterior cruciate ligament if the graft is too tight. Internal and external rotation should be evaluated as well. It is best done with the leg flexed at 90 degrees in both knee and hip. Grasp the heel with one hand and rotate the lower leg with the other. Since both collateral ligaments are relaxed in this position, external rotation of up to 20 degrees and internal rotation of up to 10 degrees should be achievable. Pay attention to pain or mechanical resistance, which can be seen in meniscal tears or if a torn meniscus is trapped. The next step tests lateral translational movement. Stabilize the thigh with one hand while moving the lower leg laterally and medially with the other. Pain is a sign of meniscal damage, and increased lateral translation indicates lesions of the cruciate ligaments. The final part of the examination assesses abduction and adduction. In a healthy individual and with the knee maximally extended, the collateral ligaments and joint capsule prevent both abduction and adduction. Repeat the test with the knee flexed at 20 degrees. In this position, adduction of around 10 and abduction of around 5 degrees is considered physiological.